Many American blacks are keen to tell you bullshit stories that their ancestors built the pyramids. That is preposterous, and it insults those people whose ancestors really did build the pyramids. Modern Egyptians. Although the ancestors of American blacks didn't build the pyramids, they did build Stonehenge. Bear with me. This is an idea which needs thinking about clearly, and you need to follow the logic carefully. Nobody has a single black ancestor, or a single white ancestor. Anybody who has the slightest hint of mixed blood has millions of ancestors representing every race which makes up their unique genetic recipe. That thought will not sit well with the likes of black supremacists, who are somehow prepared to acknowledge the existence of a single evil white rapist ancestor, but won't accept the simple fact that everybody has an enormous number of ancestors, including all our ancestors. They, too, had billions of ancestors. That solitary rapist, as the black supremacist likes to think of, had just as many ancestors as everybody else in his family tree. He would have had a white father, a white mother, two white grandfathers, four white great-grandmothers, eight white great-great-grandfathers, and so on. The chances that every single one of those people was an evil monster is clearly not worth speculating about. Of course, plenty of them must have been predominantly decent men and women, and the chances are that any American black born in the 20th or 21st century would have had several different white ancestors from different sides of his family. Almost every American black family has some white blood, and therefore has billions of white ancestors. And most of those billions of white ancestors never saw a black man. If you're not very mathematically minded, this might be hard to get your head around, but it's worth the effort. Imagine you are 30 years old today. That makes your birth year 1983 or 1984. Statistically speaking, the average human generation step is 28 years. Of course, some people have children at the age of 15 or so, but that is counterbalanced by parents, especially fathers, who have children in their 50s. 28 is the average. I have checked against my family tree and it works. It's also the age gap between myself and my parents. 20 years back from 1983 is 1955. If you are 30 years old, the chances are that your parents were born close to the year 1955. So in 1955, your genetic material was being carried by two people. Go back another generation, approximately 1927, and your genetic material will be distributed among your four great-grandparents. My two parents were born in 1935, and my four grandparents were born between 1899 and 1908. Going back further, the spread of birth dates gets wider and the number of gaps and uncertainties increases. There are also some slots in the family tree which are duplicated. I know because I've checked that these duplications began in my family tree around the middle of the 19th century. I would be highly surprised if anybody was able to trace their family back to 1750 was not to unearth some degree of inbreeding. That's just the way humanity has always worked. Just think about most of human prehistory. People living in bands of no more than 150 people. Everybody you ever met was likely to be a third cousin or better. The aristocracy and royalty face the same situation today. It's not an evil plot. It's just the way the sums have to work in a limited population size. Back to the hypothetical 30-year-old. Between 1890 and 1910, he is likely to have had eight grandparents. If he is a black man from the USA with no obvious recent African connection, it is likely that two or three of those great-grandparents were a quarter or an eighth, or perhaps two or three different eighths, white. By the time we get back to the year 1492 and the discovery of the Americas by Europeans, we'll be going back 17 and a half generations. Work it out for yourself. Doubling in every generation by 1492, we come to a figure of close to 200,000 ancestors. A million ancestors, or at least a million slots on your family tree, comes around the year 1300. And then we can do the 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, and so on again, but now dealing with millions. We hit the billion mark around the year 1000 AD. And of course, a mere 28 years before that, it has doubled again to 2 billion, and so on. So your black supremacist has to acknowledge that by the time Stonehenge was built, the number of slots on his family tree which had to be filled by white people will be significantly bigger than the entire population of Europe. In fact, it will be significantly bigger than the entire human race was, is, or will ever likely to become. If any of those men, women and children who built Stonehenge have any descendants alive today, 4,000 years later, and of course, many of them wouldn't have any, then it is extremely likely that they are related to virtually every American black alive today, as well as every white person with English ancestry. Although, of course, Barack Obama, a genuine African American, as opposed to an American black, would only be related via his mother and the billions of white ancestors he studiously ignores and shamelessly denigrates.